something? I've finally got your number.
Good, good.
You're Rita's brother-in-law.
You win the Cupid doll.
I used to know Rita.
Is that a fact?
Do you want to dance?
Well, I have to get some food to take back to the table.
Okay, that settles now. How about later?
You have a lot of drive, don't you?
After you're finished with the food, like swimming.
Like swimming? I don't follow.
Like swimming, you wait a few minutes after you eat before you jump in again.
Oh, yeah. Well, that does stand to reason.
Well, shall we say 5 minutes? I'll keep an eye on your table.
Well, let's not pin it down. Maybe 20 minutes or a half hour, huh?
Play it by ear. You, go with her?
Right.
She dig you?
Yeah, she digs me.
Me too.
Well, that's very flattering, thank you.
Speak up, I can't hear you.
I said that's... Forget it.
Hey, you know what?
What?
I've been out of town for a while.
Great.
But I'm back now.
Yeah, well, I'll tell Rita you were asking about it.
Oh, I'm sorry, Rita.
Yeah, I bet you are, Sandy.
Oh, it was an accident. I'm such a klutz.
Mm-hmm.
You better go wipe it off before it stains, honey.
Excuse me, Ron.
Well, now will you dance? There's just the two of us left.
That wasn't very smart.
Come on, if you don't get some exercise, you are going to disintegrate and go piffle.
Okay. My wife.
Says here the Mets beat them 8-0. The way they've been playing, the Toledo Mudhens could beat them.
Is that any way to talk about our boys? Oh, Charlie, I tell you, this is great.
The Red Sox? Are you kidding? What's the matter?
Just sitting here talking about baseball.
Look who's back, Charlie. I saw your sign in the window.
What sign?
Oh, didn't you see it? Experienced waitress wanted.
No thanks, Sandy.
Oh, well, let's try a test.
It's been twice now, Sandy. We have this little game going. I hire Sandy. She works up a clientele. She quits, they leave. Then she comes back and we play ring around the counter all over again.
Third time's the charm, Charlie. Yes, sir, what would you like?
I've got...
There's breakfast number one scrambled egg and three wheat cakes, or breakfast number two scrambled eggs and 4 wheat... Ah, don't touch that.
That's the way to get your fingers bit.
2 weeks old, it figures. And, knowing Charlie, this is yesterday's warm-ups.
She makes great coffee, but she can talk you to death.
All right, what would you like? One, two, or three?
I told you I ordered.
You're a tough customer, Mr. Harrington.
I don't like playing games.
Any kind?
Not the kind where you dance with a girl and her husband busts in and says, "That's my wife."
Where's your sense of mystery?
Gone. And my sense of humor.
Hey. I'm sorry if that bugged you last night, honestly.
OK. can I read my paper?
Only if you have a decent breakfast. You're going to work in the garage all day, and you need a decent breakfast. Now, what'll it be? One, two, or three?
You pick.
Number one, numero uno, for Mr. Harrington. You see how easy it is to get a steady customer.
Sticking a call radio in the tow truck. You've got to be state approved to take emergency calls on the turnpike.
Well, then wouldn't you have to get another man, especially for that?
If I could get the business, it'd be worth it, wouldn't it? Is this allowed?
I didn't say we had to act like strangers.
Well, you make up the rules, Princess. Got to keep me posted.
Am I back to being Princess again?
Slipped out.
Do you know what you want?
Ooh, we haven't even looked at the menu yet.
Take your time.
I'd like a tuna sandwich, please, on white bread, and apple cider.
Make that two apple ciders.
Anything else?
No, that'll be fine, thanks.
Nifty.
Well, I wish I could stay and have lunch with you, but it really wouldn't be too fair to the help, would it?
Did Lee ever say anything?
You mean like what time I'm supposed to be back?
No, I know you're the boss.
I'd love to have lunch with you, but I can't.
I know.
I was over at the college today to pick up the Film Society schedule, and you know who I saw?
What?
Norman. Norman was there.
Oh, really?
Thank you.
That was fast?
Nobody's ever accused me of being slow. I'll have your sandwich in a minute.
So tell me about Norman.
I just saw him walking into the administration building.
Did you talk to him?
No, I called to him, but I guess he didn't hear me. Do you suppose he's thinking of college?
Oh, I hope so. It's so critical for him. Allison, I've got to get going. Now, you pick out what films you want to see, and I'll buy the tickets.
I guess nobody ever accused you of being slow. You really inhaled that cider.
Yeah, well, mechanicking's thirsty business.
Tell me about it sometime. Did, my husband say anything to you about last night?
What?
He's a big guy with fists. He's a big guy, period. Not that you're any midget.
Listen, I didn't like the idea of him hitting you. I didn't interfere because I thought it might go a little worse for you. After all, you have to go home with him.
After all.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Rodney.
I'll call you.
That what you always call him? Rodney?
That's his name.
Well, I didn't mean for you to call him Mr. Harrington, but, Rodney?
It's his name.
You two going steady?
Not exactly.
Just friends?
I didn't say that.
Engaged?
No, no, we're not.
About to be engaged, or just, having fun?
We go out.
Private property, keep off.
What about you? Are you just friends with Lee Weber?
We're married.
That's what I thought. I bet that's what your husband thinks, too.
Good morning.
Morning.
Lee around?
Nope.
Hey.
What?
How come you bought this place?
Felt like it.
How come you didn't fire Lee?
He's a good mechanic.
You should have.
How come?
Well, he's no gentleman.
So what?
You are.
Tell me, where'd you ever get a word like that?
Out of the dictionary. I'll bet you thought I couldn't even spell it.
You know what? I think you could spell it backwards.
See, you are a gentleman. I see you with a briefcase and a rolled-up umbrella.
Oh, you mean an English gentleman?
Huh?
Well, that's where they come from. England.
Oh.
Look, Mrs. Weber.
Sandy.
Oh, no, no. A gentleman would always call you Mrs. Weber. And you do want me to remain a gentleman, don't you?
Absolutely.
Lee should be back in a few minutes.
You know something? You remind me of Chris. Lee's brother. He's blind.
Oh, yes, I heard.
Ever met him?
No, no, I never met him.
Hmm. You and he have both been through a lot. Your trial.
Yes, but my trial is over. He's still blind.
I wish he'd come back.
I told you he'd be back in a few minutes.
I'm not talking about Lee.
Why did you come back, Sandy?
I got lonely.
You still look lonely.
You do throw yourself around a lot.
But you see right through me. I'm just a sweet, lonely girl at heart.
Are you?
What?
Lonely?
Sure.
Boy, you're tough.
You're forgetting to be a gentleman. You were going to call me Mrs. Weber, remember?
Hello, Mr. Harrington. Mrs. Weber.
I was looking for you.
Why, what's up?
Nothing.
Then why look for me? You're going to be late for work. Sandy, come here. Got anything after all this time?
Yes, it is.
If it means so much to her, you start asking the questions, and if I can remember, I'll help you.
Before the incident on the bluff, was your brother accident prone?
No. He'd bang his thumb with a hammer once in a while. Once he stepped in a rabbit trap, but it was covered with snow. That's the only accident that I remember.
Of all the kids playing on the bluff that day, were any of them hostile towards your brother?
No, he was a good kid.
He still is a good kid.
Yeah, you read your book.
The president of my brother's fan club.
Did Chris have any prior medical history of dizziness or fainting spells?
No, not that I remember.
Okay, Lee. Thanks for your cooperation.
Forget it. Listen, if I do remember anything, I'll give you a call.
Appreciate that.
Does this investigation mean that you're going to go question my brother about what happened? I mean, he has enough problems as it is without bringing this up again.
Well, I understand that. But I'm afraid I might have to question him. I might not have any other choice.
Well, supposing after this whole thing's over, you find out that Miss Howard really did it.
Well, she knows that's a possibility. She still wants to find out the truth.
Well, I guess we have to give her credit for that, don't we?
Thanks again, Lee. Mrs. Weber?
With a shovel, didn't you? You should get a medal for that performance. It's too bad you let Chris sit up there in Boston like he's got some kind of a disease.
Knock it off, Sandy.
Why can't we ever go and see him? He's begged you. I begged you.
You sure know how to get...
Hi.
Come here. Who's that girl?
What girl?
The girl who just left.
I don't know.
Sandy.
I'm your wife, not a social director.
How much do I owe you, honey?
Oh, 65 cents.
Here. Keep it.
Thank you.
Your hair's messed up.
So what?
Coffee. You were gone this morning when I woke up. Why?
Felt like getting out early. It looked like it was going to be a beautiful day.
And you wanted some fresh air, huh?
Lee, I didn't want to wake you.
I bet. You know, I might have wanted to drive you to work or maybe have a cup of coffee with you or something. That would have spoiled your beautiful day, huh?
I told you, I just wanted to get out.
What time does he usually come in?
What are you talking about?
The boy tycoon. Handsome Rodney Harrington. Doesn't he usually make it a point to stop in the morning for a little pick-me-up?
You've got a wild imagination.
Well, you knew that when you married me. And I guess I knew about you, too. What about the girl? You know anything?
I've seen her on the wharf.
She come in often?
A couple of times.
Talk to her?
No.
Well, the next time she comes in, you make it a point to find out something about her.
I look sideways at someone and you're ready to knock my head off. But you can ask me to fill you in on someone. Well, you can forget about her. She's out of your class. She's a doctor.
A doctor?
Anyway, something like that at the hospital.
She works at the hospital? What do you know?
Who is she?
She's a lady doctor.
Oh, that's cute. You do know her, don't you, Lee?
Yeah. Ann Colby.
Who?
The girl who shoved my brother off the bluff. That's who it is.
Well, are you sure?
Yeah, I'm gonna make sure.
Been sitting here. I get to work early at the hospital.
Why don't you finish your coffee, Miss Howard?
No,
please.
Really, I am late.
You know, we're going to be bumping into each other a lot. I don't want you to think you have to run every time you see me. You know, when I stopped by the hospital the other day, I let go with a lot of stuff that's been building up in me for years. I shouldn't have done that.
Well, I'd have been surprised if our first meeting was anything different.
Well, I wish it hadn't. But maybe it's best to clear the air like that, right up front.
You know, I won't pretend I've hated you for years. The other day when I went home, I thought about all those things I said over and over in my head. And I thought about how stupid they were. I owe you an apology. I hope you accept.
Oh, I'm not quite sure I know what you did.
Well, I'd like to apologize anyway.
Of course.
Honey, why don't you fill Miss Howard's cup up?
Oh, sure. Oh, I didn't realize. Are you two?
Yeah, Mr. and Mrs. Oh. I thought professional people like you had better hours than this. You're up at the crack of dawn every morning, aren't you?
Well, I have quite a bit of a walk to get to work.
Don't you have a car?
Now, my old jalopy gave out on me about 6 months ago, and I haven't been able to afford one since.
Well, you're talking to the right guy. That's my line. I work down at the Shoreline Garage. Yeah, we get a used buggy in now and then. In fact, if you're interested, we have one you can step into right now. It needs a little work, but I can put it in top running condition by tomorrow night.
Well, if I could afford it.
You can afford it. I'll see to that.
That's very nice of you.
Well, I owe it to you.
Oh, and I owe you how much?
Oh, well, 75 cents.
Thank you, Sandy.
Thank you.
You will get in touch with me about the car.
Sure.
Good. Bye.
Bye.
Lee?
Hmm?
That's the first time I ever heard you apologize to anybody.
So
why?
Well, can't a man apologize when he feels like it?
Not you and not to her. Ever since I've known you, I've listened to you say what you'd do to the girl who blinded Chris if you ever met her again.
Is that right? What's wrong with the coffee today? It's pretty bad.
Lee.
Yeah?
Don't do anything.
What do you mean?
You know. To her, don't hurt her.
Well, what gives you the idea that I'm going to hurt her?
I know you, Lee. Look, it was so long ago.
Yeah, it was a long time ago, but it happened, Dig. And for a long, long time, my brother's been blind. It wasn't my idea her coming back, but she did. And now I got my own ideas.
Lee.
It's my name.
Thank you.
Rod?
Hello, Sandy. Lee isn't here right now.
Well, can I wait for him?
Yeah, if you like.
Hello, Miss Howard.
Hi, Sandy. Well, thanks again. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Hello, Miss Howard. Why don't you wait in the office? You'll be more comfortable.
I knew Lee wasn't here.
No more games. Okay, Sandy.
I've got to talk to you seriously. I'm worried about Lee.
Why come to me?
Well, Lee works for you.
Yeah, that's fine, but it doesn't make me a marriage counselor. I'm not qualified.
You still mad about the other night?
No, I'm flattered. Oh, but let's drop it, okay?
Lee's acting a little weird.
That's what I mean. We drop it.
Listen, big man. I'm not thinking about you. I'm thinking about that woman.
That's a change.
Are you gonna listen to me?
Shoot.
She's the one everyone said did it.
What?
Oh, you know, pushed Lee's brother off Sailor's Bluff. Now Lee's acting nice to her.
Well, so?
Lee hates her.
Look, that happened a long time ago. Lee could have become able to handle the situation. You just don't bond hating people.
Who doesn't?
I'm talking about your husband.
No. No, you're not talking about Lee. Lee carries things inside. He's gonna do something. I know it. He always said he would. And I'm scared.
Well, what do you want me to do?
I don't know. You could talk to him.
You think he's gonna listen?
Make him listen.
How?
How? I don't know. Someday Lee's gonna kill somebody. I know it.
Ann Howard?
Somebody, anybody.
Sandy, why'd you marry him?
I was afraid of him.
I was afraid, and then I run away, and then I'm afraid to be away. I'm mixed up about